Hello, my name is Jonah Maiarelli. I am the creative director of Maiarelli Studio and I'm a graphic designer. I started making collages at the end of 2015 and it was a New Year's resolution. I decided that throughout 2016 I would make a collage every day from the New York Times. The impetus for making collages was going back to working with my hands. When I started my career as a graphic designer, we would create ideas and present our projects to our clients with things that we make with our hands. We would cut paper, we would lay type down, and it would all be done manually. And somehow I have been missing lately the link between my brain and my hands. The idea behind all the collages that I make, whether it's my New York Times project or any other collages, is that I work from a single source. That really forces me to find the material no matter what, and really to look beyond. And in a way, it's similar to what I do in my job as a creative communicator. You know, I don't do art, I solve problems. I work within the confines of a brief. It's a good exercise to train your eyes to not just to look, but to really find things. And the most fascinating things is that often is the leftovers that are more interesting. It's the pieces of paper that you actually cut out an image out of that become the more interesting part, or what I call the negative spaces. During the course of my 2016 New York Times New Year's resolution project, I used to go back to my studio at night after dinner and try to work for 20 minutes, half an hour, no more than that. And like any good meditation, I found that it opened up space for more creativity. So the morning after, I would wake up and I would feel energized from a creative point of view. I didn't end up making 365 collages that year in 2016, but I made about 100 and I kept working doing my New York Times collages since then. I also work with vintage magazines and old books. Sometimes I go to the Strand and there are these boxes where they sell old catalogs and books. That's all good material for me. And I like matte paper. I don't like anything too glossy. I just don't like the results. My preference is to use images that are black and white. I love faces. They offer a lot of possibilities. And when you don't have one, you can always make a face with other objects, elements. I want to emphasize the fact that when I'm making my collages, I don't pretend to make art. It's really more about an exercise, a creative exercise, and it's really about the process more than the outcome. All you need to start making collages are a bunch of old newspapers and magazines, a pair of good scissors, and an X-Acto knife. For glue, I normally use a glue stick made by a Japanese company called Craft Design Technology. I'm sure it's not the choice of professional artists. They would be using something called acrylic medium. But if you don't have that at home right now, any stick of glue would work. Okay, so this is the New York Times from Sunday. I often find that I don't find the best images in the news section. And also, unfortunately, the paper is not printed as well as it used to be, even a few years ago. This is nice, and I'm gonna cut it out. It's a silhouette that makes this image interesting for me, so I don't care about the background. This type of images could be useful as sort of graphic elements and backdrops. I'm not going to cut it now, but I might, or images like this as well. But I know they're here in case I need them. You know, of course, you can also use the text as an interesting texture, you know. I'm against using art, but maybe I can reinterpret this or use a detail only.
I think a man all dressed in red could be interesting. Caribou, a man in red, and a Flemish painting. Great. Okay, Sunday Review could be good. Before I cut, I always check the back to make sure that there is something even better in the back. And here's a picture of somebody wearing a mask. Sports, I do get material from sports, especially vintage photographs like that one. Making a collage by hand for me is nothing more than pushing pieces of paper around until I find something that speaks to me. Often it's not what I envisioned when I was cutting the newspaper, because what you plan in your mind frequently turns out to be too obvious, and when art is obvious, it's irrelevant and even condescending. And I love the concept of opening yourself to the unexpected. It's very liberating and it's extremely exciting, especially because I'm working with a limited palette. So I think this is going to be my collage for the New York Times of Sunday, April 12. I added this bit of type that says hope, even if it's visually unnecessary, because it's, I guess, appropriate for the times we're living in. When you work from a newspaper, it's inevitable that sometimes current events play a part. I cannot glue the collage because I've run out of glue. I ordered it from a couple of different places, but they didn't deliver it on time for this video. I hope that this short video has inspired you to make your own collages, and I hope you have a lot of fun doing it.